Well, in the previous chapter, we learned about regression when we had just one dependent variable and one independent variable. And in this chapter, we're going to be able to work with multiple regression, which means we will have more than one independent variable. What you're looking at here is a multiple regression equation. It's a little bit more complex simply because we have more x values than what we looked at in the last chapter, but we still have y hat, the predicted value of y. And that equals the intercept a plus the slope of x variable 1 plus the slope of times x variable 2, and so on and so forth. So all we're going to do is we're going to use Excel's regression analysis to come up with the slopes of each of those variables. We can then predict a value of y based on the value of x's that we have. And it'll be very, very easy to do within Excel's data analysis. The example we're going to work with, that's also in your textbook for multiple regression, is a realty firm. When people are interested in buying a house, they always seem to ask the realtor, how much is it going to cost to heat this house? Well, the heating cost is going to be the dependent variable. That's what he's going to try to predict. Now, he's going to use three independent variables, the mean outside temperature, the amount of insulation in the attic, and the age of the furnace in an attempt to predict. So he's assuming in this case that those independent variables are going to affect the cost of heating the house, which in this case is the dependent variable. Well, here we see the result of a multiple regression done in Excel with data analysis. And as before, there will be a quick tutorial included in Blackboard so that you can see how this is done. But you can see that we have the temperature, the insulation, and the age. We have the slope for each of those computed, as well as the intercept. So then we're able to build our multiple regression equation using the information that Excel gives us. All right, so taking that information from the Excel result, we actually are able to build then a multiple regression equation. We end up with the intercept of 427 minus, we have a negative slope for x variable 1, a negative slope for x variable 2, and a positive slope for x variable 3. So as you can see down here at the bottom, once we know the values for x1, x2, and x3, we're then able to predict a monthly charge to heat the house. You might remember we used the R and the R square to determine the strength of the relationship or the correlation between the variables here. Now, you'll notice that we have something called a coefficient of multiple determination that is still R square. In this case, the R square is 0.83. Now, because the larger number of independent variables that we throw into a regression, it can actually affect that or skew that a little bit. So oftentimes we'll use the adjusted R-square, which is a little bit more accurate and helps balance the effect of having multiple independent variables. Well, as we did with a single regression, with a multiple regression, we also need to perform a global test. And a global test is actually testing the hypothesis that the slope of all the independent variables is actually zero. The alternate hypothesis is that at least one of the x variables has a slope that is not equal to zero. So in layman's terms, what the global test is telling us is that is there at least one of these independent variables that is a significant predictor of the dependent variable. Well, after we've stated the null and the alternate hypothesis, we're then going to formulate a decision rule. And that decision rule is to look at the critical value and using the degrees of freedom of 3 and 16, 3 in the numerator and 16 in the denominator, we end up with a critical value of 3.24 for the F. Now, our next step is to actually compute the F, but it's already been done for us here with Excel. But we'll look at that F that we computed and compare it to the critical value to decide whether or not we're going to reject or not reject the null hypothesis. Remember, the null hypothesis in this case is that all of the slopes are zero, or none of these variables are significant predictors of the dependent variable, which in this case is the cost to heat the house. Well, as you saw, we already did compute the F with Excel, but we have an F computed of 21.9, and we're going to compare that to the critical value of F of 3.24, and of course we're much larger than that, so therefore we are going to reject the null hypothesis. Well, what does that mean? It means that at least one of the independent variables is a significant predictor of the dependent variable. Well, the F-test told us that at least one of the independent variables is a significant predictor of the dependent variable. So our next step is to actually decide which one. So to do that, we're going to actually evaluate the slope of each and every one of the independent variables, and we'll do that with a t-test. All right, with the n minus k plus 1 degrees of freedom, we've looked up a critical value for t of 2.120. Now the next step is to actually compute the t, or because Excel's already computed it for us, just look at the t that's computed and compare it to that critical value. So looking at the result of our regression analysis done in Excel, we can see that it has computed the t-stats for us. We can see the t-stat for temp is negative 5.93, the t-stat for insulation is negative 3.119, and the t-stat for age is 1.5. Well, the next thing to do, of course, is to compare the t-stat that we computed to that critical value. Remember, the critical value was 2.120, so we can see in this case that we will reject the null hypothesis for both temperature and insulation, and we will assume that it is a significant predictor for the cost to heat the house. You can also do that by looking at the p-value, and the temperature p-value, Excel kind of gives you an error, but that just simply tells you it's very, very close to zero. And so the p-value is very close to zero for temperature, it's also very close to zero for insulation, but it's 0.14 for age, which is greater than our significance level of 0.05. And this slide is just a graph that shows us how each of the t-stats that we've computed falls within the reject or do not reject area based on the critical value. Since we know that the age of the furnace is not a significant predictor of the cost of heating a house, what we'd want to do next is to actually run the regression analysis again without the age as one of the independent variables. And when we do, we can see that we have a little bit more accurate result. Notice that the F stat is a little bit higher. We also have the T stats computed for the X variable 1 and X variable 2, which is the outside temperature and the insulation that we have. And we can also see that the R square actually is a little bit smaller than what we had before, but it is more accurate because we have only included significant predictors of the cost to heat the house based on our multiple regression analysis. Well, the other thing that we consider that might be a factor in the cost of heating a house is whether or not the house has a garage. Now, in this case, whether or not, yes or no, is not a numeric value or quantitative value. It is a qualitative value. However, it is possible to translate some qualitative variables, especially those that are yes, no, or categorical, into numeric values. And so in this case, we're going to create what we call a dummy variable, and we're going to say 0 if it doesn't have a garage and 1 if it does. Then we'll go ahead and be able to perform a multiple regression using that numeric coded dummy variable as one of the independent variables. Well, here we see the result of the multiple regression done in Excel using the dummy variable for garage, 0 for no garage and 1 if it does have a garage. And if you look down at the result, X variable 3, which is the garage, I just didn't change, Excel actually puts the variables in as X variable 1, X variable 2, and to make it make more sense, you could easily change that to, as I did in the other slide, to temperature, insulation, and garage. But X variable 3 is the garage. We look at the T stat of the garage, and we see that it is 3.398. The critical value that we computed before with its number of degrees of freedom was 2.12. And we can see in this case that yes, this also is a significant predictor of the cost of heating a house. And so we have now a new multiple regression equation that we'll explore on the next slide. So based on the results of our multiple regression data analysis, we have now a new multiple regression equation, and we can see that the predicted value of y, which is the cost to heat the house per month, is 394 minus 3.96x1, which was the temperature outside, and then we have minus 1.3x2, which was the inches of insulation, plus 77.4x3, or x4 as it says here, which was the whether or not the dummy variable, whether or not it has a garage. So again, popping in values for x1, x2, and x3 or x4, we have then the cost that we predict to heat the house.